Hello everyone. So in this video we are going to see one of the root of the equation, that is a Newton-Raphson method, and we have to solve the numerical with the help of iteration criteria. So in this video we are going to see the Newton-Raphson method. Newton-Raphson method, it is an open-end method. In this method we assume a single initial case to find a solution. Okay, so we'll directly go to the numerical. Here the numerical is given, that is using Newton-Raphson method, and initial guess as 0, find x cube minus 5x plus 3 which is equal to 0, and you have to go for 3 iterations. Okay, so actually what is given? Yes, first of all you have to solve with the help of Newton-Raphson method, and the initial guess which is given, that is 0, and the function is given, that is x cube minus 5x plus 3. So you will solve this. So starting, the function is f of x which is given x cube minus 5x plus 3 equal to 0, and next the initial guess is also given, that is x1 which is equal to 0, okay, and number of iterations is also given, n equal to 3. So in Newton-Raphson method only one initial guess is required. Okay, if initial guess, now in this numerical directly the initial guess is given, that is 0. If initial guess is not given, then at that case you have to assume the initial guess, okay, and you have to verify whether the initial guess is right or wrong. For that condition is there. Okay, so if whether this initial guess which is given by the given in numerical is right or wrong, so that condition we have to verify. First of all, here the x1 value is directly given. There is no need to verification, but we should know the condition how to verify. So we'll directly see whether the initial guess is right or wrong. For that condition is, condition whether this x1 which is given is right or wrong. For that condition is there. Yes, f of x1 into f of double dash x1 should divide by bracket f double dash, sorry, f dash single dash of x1 bracket square. So this mod should be less than 1. Okay, so formula is, or the equation is, f of x1 into f double dash of x1 divided by f single dash of x1 bracket square should be less than 1. Okay, so what is required? First of all, you require the value of f of x1, value of f double dash of x1, and value of f dash of x1. So first of all, calculate all the values. Okay, so next you have to calculate f of x, function of x1, that will be, so function is x cube minus 5x plus 3, so your function will be x1 cube minus 5x1 plus 3. Okay, so x1 is 0 now. Okay, put the value of x1 as 0, as we assume, or the which is given, that is x1 is given as 0. Here 0 cube minus 5 into 0 plus 3, so this will be 3. Okay, so value of x, f of x1 will be 3. Next, function of x1, so function of x1, first of all find out the function of x1, so that will be 3 x1 square minus 5. Okay, so this will be the f dash of x1. Put the value of x1 as 0. So it will be 3 into 0 square minus 5 equal to minus 5. Okay. Next, you have to find out f double dash of x1. So further derivative, if you take, so that will be, yes, it will be 6x1. Okay, so this will be constant, it will be 0, equal to 6 into 0, it will be 0. So f double dash will be 0. Okay, so in this way we have find out, first of all, f of x1, f dash of x1 and f double dash of x1. Further, what we have to do, we have to put the values of this x1, f of x1, f dash of x1 and f double dash of x1 in this equation and find out whether it is less than 1 or not. So we'll solve. Further, equation is, yes, f of x1 into f double dash of x1, okay, it should be divided by f dash of x1 bracket square, should be less than 1. Okay, put the values. So what was value? This f of x1 is 3, f dash of x1 is minus 5 and f double dash is 0. So this is 3 into 0 divided by minus 5 bracket square, mod of this should be less than 1. So this numerator is 0, so answer will be 0, which is less than 1. Okay, so initial guess is what we have considered or what is given, that is x1 equal to 0, so that is correct. Okay, now further, as we know the initial guess is right, actually in this numerical the initial guess is given, there is no need of finding whether it is right or wrong, but we should have the idea how to find out. Okay, now directly go to the iteration first. Okay, for iteration first, we know the value of x1 is 0, that we have, that is already given. Okay, so calculate the new value of root. So new value of root can be calculated by the equation f of x1 equal to x cube minus 5x plus 3. So the equation, in that equation you have to put the value of x1 equal to 0. Further, so it will be, yes, x cube minus 5 into 0 plus 3. Instead of x cube you have to put 0. So further, it will be equal to 3. So f of x1 is 3 now, and find out f dash of x1, that will be 3x square minus 5 equal to 3 into 0 square minus 5 equal to minus 5. Okay, now we have to put the value of this f of x1 and f dash of x1 in Newton-Raphson method formula. So what is that formula? So formula for Newton-Raphson method is x2, that we have to find out, is equal to x1 minus f of x1 divided by f dash of x1. Okay, so we have the value of f of x1, that is 3, and f dash equal as minus 5. Okay, so put the values, we will get 0 minus 3 minus minus 5 okay, which will be equal to 0.6. okay, now this is a value of x2 will be 0.6. x2 will be 0.6 for the first iteration. For first iteration, the value of x2 will be 6. Now what you have to do, you have to go for next iteration. So for next iteration, replace x2 by x1. How many iteration you have to perform? You have to perform 3 iteration. So replace x2 by x1. So new value of x1 will be 0.6. Now x1 will be 0.6. You have to replace x2 by x1 and go for next iteration. Iteration second. So second iteration is there. Perform second iteration, same process you have to follow. Okay, so here now x1 will be equal to 0.6. calculate the new root. So the function is f of x1 equal to x cube minus 5x plus 3. So instead of x, now what you have to put? You put the value, that is 0.6. okay, so it will be 0.6 bracket cube minus 5 into 0.6 plus 3, so that will be equal to 0.216. okay, so afterwards you have got the value of f of x1. Next you have to find out the value of f dash of x1. So f dash of x1, which will be equal to 3x square minus 5 equal to 0.6. We have put on the value of x as 0.6 square minus 5. So which further f dash of x1 will get minus 3.92. okay, now further what you have to do, you have to find out the value of x2. Formula is x1 minus f of x1 divided by f dash of x1. So put the values in Newton-Raphson method formula. Here x1 is 0.6 minus 0.216 divided by minus 3.92. You will get the answer, x2 will be equal to 0.6551. okay, so this is x2 for iteration second. Okay, now replace this x2, replace x2 by x1. Now the new value of x1 will be 0.6551 for the next iteration. So iteration number 3. So this is last iteration. Here again value of x1 is given. X1 is now 0.6551. So further function of x1, f of x1 is equal to x cube minus 5x plus 3. Put the values of x1, you will get 0.0056. okay, further if you put the value of x1 here in this equation, you will get f of x1 as 0.0056. Next you have to find out the value of f dash of x1, which is equal to 3x square minus 5, which is equal to, put the value of x1 as 0.6551.
you will get minus 3.7125. So this is value of f dash of x1. Next step is to find out value of x2. X2 which is equal to x1 minus f of x1 divided by f dash of x1. Put the value of, so this is x1 and this is f dash of x1. Put the values 0.65551 minus 0.00056 divided by minus 3.7125. You'll get a value of x2 which will be equal to 0.6566. So this is the value that we have got for iteration third. As mentioned, you have to perform only three iterations. So at the last, you have got the value of x2, that is 0.6566, so which is a required value of the equation. Okay, so this is the required root of the equation. So required root of the equation is, at last you have to write down like this, required root of equation is 0.6566. Okay, so I hope you understood the numerical. Thank you. Thanks for watching.